This is the story of a great team, a great and young team. Only 5 years ago, Yves Wertz, René Verbiest and Vincent Vos created the W Racing team, but they've come a long way in such a short time. WRT is a family that lives together most of the year, going from one circuit to the next all around the world. WRT is a team of men and women who have enabled an extraordinary list of achievements. It is the story of this great, beautiful team that we will tell you just now. It all started with the first victory at the 10 Hours of Zolder in 2010 and the Belkar Championship titles for both individual drivers and teams, which sparked a winning streak. The 24 Hours of Spa in 2011 are certainly one of the team's most important victories. Audi Sport trusts the young Belgian team to go fetch the one victory that the brand still misses at the time. The team can count on Audi's support just 1 year after being set up. Dr. Wolfgang Ulrich himself is present in the WRT box. That tells a lot about the brand's expectations and the pressure on the shoulders of Vincent Vos and his crew. Everything runs like clockwork, the strategy is effective, the pit stops are streamlined, and the German brand has put the finest drivers behind the steering wheel of its R8 number 33.
We have to try this.
Timo Scheider and Matthias Ekström, together with Greg Franke, deliver a perfect performance and offer Audi its very first victory on the Belgian circuit.
Do you win the checkered flag, or do you want to put Matthias on the car?
My name is Timo Scheider. When I start something, I finish something.
This 2011 success will be without a doubt the defining moment for the team. A victory that arrives nearly too early for this team that is just 1 year old and still has a lot to learn. Thanks to this victory at the 24 Hours of Spa, Greg Franke has earned a nice little capital of points for the Blancpain Endurance Championship. Facing very harsh competition, Franke in the number 33 manages to snatch the championship title, and WRT gets its first international crown. In addition to the first victory in the 24 Hours of Zolder and the Team of the Year title awarded by the Royal Automobile Club of Belgium, 2011 is a complete success for WRT. All these titles are certainly great rewards, but the most important for WRT is the trust of the German firm. At the end of the season, Audi has to fight at the other end of the globe, at the 12 Hours of Sepang in Malaysia, and Audi picks René Verbiest and his team for this delicate mission. Fassler, Biela, Werner, among others, are the dedicated R8 drivers in Malaysia. And that country represents an important market for the Ingolstadt company.
10 seconds.
The temperature is close to 40 degrees Celsius. Both men and machines are suffering from the heat.
5.7 seconds advantage. I was unlucky with the traffic.
Audi quickly takes the lead of the competition. In the end, WRT finishes the race in second position with a flat tire just minutes before the end, after spending most of the race in the top spot. It closes a fantastic season and gives an encouraging signal for 2012. This success means that WRT is now famous internationally, so it has to grow to match this stature. The workshop in Frameries is now too small, so WRT moves to Beaudour in a bigger facility that matches its high ambitions. During the 2012 season, WRT focuses on endurance racing, in particular 24-hour competitions. It is the first time that Yves Werthers and his men tackle the green hell with a car. The late Alan Simonsen is part of the crew of four with one single goal, learning the 24 hours of Nürburgring, the most dangerous race in the world. WRT is challenging the rival team, Phoenix, on its territory.
Please tell us when you are pit lane entry and flash your lights when you come in.
The R8 number 4 does way more than defending its place. It is actually among the front runners and maintains the right pace without pushing too hard. In this unique race, the team has a lot to learn, and in that sense, the mission is 100% accomplished. But luck is always an unpredictable factor. About halfway through the competition, a small crash that could have been harmless actually ruins the race for Andrea Piccini and his teammates.
Top right damage.
Is it serious?
Yeah, it's quite serious. Quite serious. I can't come back. The car is vibrating quite a lot. Sorry for that.
WRT's first experience in the 24 hours of Nürburgring ends up at the bottom of the standing, but that's not the most important result. Audi and Team Phoenix win the competition, and WRT has earned more experience to come back even stronger next time to the Nordschleife. A few weeks later, it's time for revenge for the two enemy brothers. This time, Phoenix is challenging WRT on Belgian ground. WRT holds the title, so the pressure is high and the race doesn't go as planned. WRT has two cars in the running. The racing conditions are appalling, and the team has the necessary experience to know how to adapt its strategy very quickly. In the morning, WRT still has good hopes. Audi has two cars in first and third position, but a flat tire and an off-track overrun will change everything. The Belgian team is hugely disappointed, even if Mies, Haas and Ortelli finish in second position. Phoenix wins in Francorchamps and the victory still belongs to Audi, but that second place leaves WRT with a bitter aftertaste. The 24 hours marathon is not over. In Zolder, at the end of the summer 2012, Audi is unbeatable. Laurens Vandoorne wins his first 24-hour race and the second one on this Belgian circuit in his backyard. In addition to these 24-hour races, WRT takes part in the GT1 Sprint Championship and wins the first two races of the season. The end of the season is even more successful for the Belgian team. In the competition before last of the Blancpain Endurance Championship on the Paul Ricard circuit, everything falls into place.
Too much forest here.
Against the VDS BMW team, the last remaining contender for the title, WRT's performance is perfect. The two Christophers, Mies and Hasse, together with Stefan Ortelli, will receive the title for both drivers and team during the following race in Navarra. This additional title crowns a difficult season. Since the early days, the team has snatched at least one victory per year, and it's not over. A team always has to go through hard times, incidents, accidents that put morale to the test. In 5 years, WRT has had its share of dark moments that only made the team stronger, without ever giving up. In 2013 is certainly the most difficult season of all. In the 24 hours of Spa, WRT has 4 cars in the running, and throughout the Belgian week, the team pushes the limits constantly. The drivers keep pushing, there is no wiggle room, and on this kind of competition, this is not the best of strategies. The mechanics is suffering, and the R8 LMS Ultra of Vantor, Ortelli and Rast has to give up first. Soon after, Fassler, Zandström and Ekström also have to abandon the race. We are not even halfway through, and two cars are already out of the competition. The remaining ones have trouble keeping up with the leaders. In the middle of the night, Matt Halliday makes a mistake, leaves the track and destroys his car. The team is in shock. But Audi never gives up. When the sun rises, hope returns. Stübler, Mies and Lotterer are in fifth position. The only remaining R8 is working like a dream, and the three drivers will go snatch a spot on the podium. Reaching the third position feels like an actual victory for WRT after so much effort and so many sacrifices. The team remembers this race as a tough one that they can, however, be proud of, and they are hungry for more for the rest of the season. The season is intense as the team is taking part in both sprint and endurance competitions. From the very beginning, during the Easter Cup in Nogaro, under a pouring rain during the main race, the R8 are clearly in charge. Before losing their spots, Rast and Meyer Meinhof win the race ahead of two other Audi WRTs, led by Stiebler, Zandström, Ortelli and Vanthoor. The season starts with a bang. Three weeks later, on Laurence Vanthoor's territory in Zolder, the WRT R8 lose against Lamborghini after a very tight competition, but they occupy the second, third and fifth positions, so WRT is clearly well placed to win in the FIA GT category. The third competition takes place under the sun in Zandvoort in the Netherlands. The Audis are now decorated in black. They are out in front during the qualification rounds, but have to make do with a second position in the main race. Ortelli and Vanthoor are number two once again. They take the lead of the driver's overall standing, while Zandström and Stippler climb on the podium once again. In Slovakia, Mercedes is out in front again, but the three Belgian Audis managed to cling the second, third and fourth positions after a fight so intense that Vincent Vos would have pulled the hair off his head if he'd had any. And then Navarra is the most difficult race of the season, with a series of technical issues, disappointing results, and the Sebastian Loeb racing team that wins everything and steps back into the game. During the Baku World Challenge, the last race of the season in Azerbaijan, WRT plays for the team title and the driver's title. The three regular crews are definitely still in the running. The pressure is high, it is their first race on an urban circuit, but the R8 LMS Ultra perform remarkably well. They even seem transformed compared to the Blancpain Endurance Series. In the end, Laurence Vanthoor and Stefan Ortelli are the winners. The Belgian drivers receive the Sprint Series title and allows WRT to get the team's award after a strenuous season. The drivers and team managers are in the front line during the whole season, but behind the scenes, many engineers, mechanics, logistics specialists, cooks, and many more team members that are impossible to list here, they all make this dream possible. They are the first and the last on the circuit, and the motivation remains intact. WRT owes them all its successes and its victories. Between 2013 and 2014, the team gets even stronger as it recruits new engineers, and Thierry Tassin will help Pierre Dieudonné in his role as team manager. July 2014. When WRT arrives in Spa for the 24 hours, the team is tense. Of course, WRT is better prepared than ever. Audi and Dr. Ulrich fully trust the team, with four cars and the best GT drivers in the world, as well as Trélier, Fassler and Lotterer, won three times in Le Mans. There is enormous pressure on Vincent Voss and his crew, even higher since Phoenix won the 24 hours of Nürburgring a few weeks earlier. WRT and Audi are not the favorites on paper, but their mission is clear. They have to win. The beginning of the race is incredibly intense. From the sidelines, it's impossible to imagine that the drivers have started 24 hours earlier. They all maintain a tremendous speed, so we expect some damage. Just a few dozen minutes after the start, first accident. But WRT is safe. The cars are back into the game and immediately, second crash. Saturday is hell. Five brakes and five safety cars. The R8 LMS Ultras are lucky and they avoid the crashes. And most of all, the drivers and the strategy masters know how to work around those unexpected events. After dark, the race settles into a nice pace, and so does WRT. The four cars keep up with the pace, and two of them are out in front, well positioned to win the competition. For a moment, Audi WRT even has three cars in the top three. In the morning, the car number three of Mies, Stiepler and Nash lags a bit behind the two leaders, and car number two of Fassler, Trélier and Lotterer has to spend a while being repaired after a small crash. On the front line, René Haas, Laurens Vanthoor and Marcus Winkelhock are playing to win against the BMW Z4 of the team VDS.
René Rast in the Audi on the back of Dirk Werner. He's got the better traction, he's got fresher tyres, but Dirk Werner is going to defend. They are absolutely together, but round the outside goes René Rast.
The BMW has the advantage that it needs fewer pit stops, but the R8 is slightly faster on the track. This is the perfect scenario to have one of the most beautiful ends in the history of the total 24 hours of Spa.
This is defensive driving, but René Rast will have a go to the outside line at
the last hours are incredibly intense and a fantastic experience to recall.
We're going to watch René Rast trying to break on the outside, get the slight advantage. No, but makes the cut back, gets up alongside and gets him through. And, I mean, eventually it was going to happen.
WRT makes no mistake, the team climbs on the first and third step of the podium, and two more cars finish the competition. We could hardly have hoped for a better result.
We fulfill this up. dit, hein, c'était un grand plaisir. Hein,
c'était voilà. Un peu stressant, mais c'était bien. Hein.
Superbe, superbe, superbe.
Thanks to this victory in Spa, Laurens Vanthoor is ahead in the Endurance Championship before starting the last race of the season, the 1,000 kilometers of Nürburgring. With César Ramos and Chris Mees, they will deliver a memorable performance under heavy rainfall. Chris Mees dares to take over his competitors in delicate situations to bring his car to the top position. Once the track is dry, Laurens Vanthoor finishes the job and wins the driver's title. WRT is the Endurance Series champion. This year, once again, WRT was fighting on every front in the Blancpain Championship. In the sprint races, the R8 LMS Seltra have led the competition with an incredible climax in Zandvoort in the Netherlands. The weekend starts on a negative note with the impressive crash of Ortelie and Roussinov. The rest of the race is more positive with a fantastic ending for René Rast against the Mercedes of HDP Motorsport. Eden Rast gave WRT its first victory of the season in the Sprint Series. Baku hosts the last race of the season once again. And once again, Audi is comfortable on this very fast urban track. The Sprint title is still within reach, but the victory seems hard to get. The team cannot control its destiny. But the WRT men will prove once again that they are simply the best. Ramos and Vanthoor win the first two rounds in Baku. To date, Audi and Laurens Vanthoor remain undefeated in Azerbaijan. In addition to this victory, WRT gets the Silver Cup title thanks to Avril and Lisowski. WRT also gets the Blancpain GT Series title in both Sprint and Endurance Series. The 2014 season ends once again on a high note, with WRT on the highest step of the podium in Baku. 2014 is the most prolific season of the team so far, with 7 titles out of 8. In 5 years, the team of Vincent Voss, Yves Wert and René Verbiest has accomplished what no other GT team had managed before. 25 titles, trophies and major awards, WRT owes this success to the Audi R8, of course, but most of all, to you all, to all the people who have worked and work to make this tremendous racing team a complete success. And it is only the beginning of the story.